you are definitely better off buying a growing company over a cheap, no growth company.
Okay.
So if I buy an asset that is cheap, that has very limited growth, all I'm going to do is cover the gap between, it may be worth 100 rupees a share, I'm getting it for 50, 60 rupees a share, I'm just going to make the 40 or 50 rupees over whatever period of time it takes to get there. Now, if I'm buying a company that has secular tailwinds, great management, and long growth engines, as long as I'm not paying up too much, it's the best place to be.